Hi students, I'm your Prasadi teacher. So today I'm going to talk about modal verbs for grade 6 students. So let's see what are the modal verbs that I have got for you. So there are 6 modal verbs here. Can, could, may, might, must and should. So can, the first modal verb. Let's see what are the uses of this modal verb. First of all, we can express abilities and also possibilities. So here are a few examples. He can speak English. Yes, of course, he can fluently speak English. Second example, I can see you. Yes, of course, I can see you clearly over there. I can hear your voice. It is very noisy, but with that voice, I can clearly hear your voice. And next example, you can be a good girl. Yes, of course, maybe you are naughty right now, but definitely you can be a good girl. So the next example, the novel can be interesting. I got a new novel today to read and probably it could be interesting. So the novel can be interesting. So the next use of can is to express permission. Let's see few examples in here. Can I stay here? I'm so tired standing out there. So can I stay here? Of course you can. Can I drink some water? I'm so thirsty. So can I drink some water? Can they sing? Of course, maybe they can sing. Okay, so next modal verb is could. Let's see what are the uses of this modal verb. Express abilities and also possibilities. So let's have a look few examples for could. It could be dangerous. Don't go there. It could be little dangerous. So be careful. You could always take a taxi. There are many vehicles, but of course, you can always take a taxi. You could easily contact me. Of course, I have your number, so you could easily contact me. Okay, so there is another use of could modal verb, that is express permission. So here are a few examples. Could I use your phone? I need to make a call. So, excuse me, could I use your phone? Could you let me go out? I'm so tired, so please let me go out. So, could you let me go out? Okay, next example. Could you send me details? I need some information of you. So, could you send me some details of you? Yes, of course. Okay, so next modal verb that we have got for you is may. Okay, so the modal verb may we can use to express possibilities. Here are a few examples. I may come tonight. Definitely, it's a party tonight, so I may come tonight. I may not be at home. Don't come today, okay? I may not be at home tonight. Yes, of course, I study so hard, so I may pass the exam, definitely. So, again, may, and this is a different use, expresses permission. So, let's see some examples. May I come in? Of course, you may. May I leave now? I need to go for a bank or for some other important work. So may I leave now? Maybe. May I take a leave tomorrow? I have a function or a wedding or some situation. So may I take a leave tomorrow? Okay, so next modal verb that I have got for you is might. So let's see what are the uses of might. Okay, so we can use might to express possibilities. So here are a few examples. It might rain. It might rain. You can see the gloomy sky and you know a cloudy weather and you can hear thundering. So it might be rain. So you better bring an umbrella. Okay, so next example I have got for you is he might not come today. You don't wait for him, so because he might not come today. He might be jealous. Yes, of course, you worked hard, so he might be get jealous. That's why he is gossiping about you. Okay, so the next modal verb that I have got for you is must. So here are the uses. So express obligation. Of course, you have to remember this. It is very vital modal verb. So here are a few examples. You must study hard. If you need to get high scores for your exam, you must study hard. Okay, next example is you must go home now. Your mom is waiting at home, so you must go home right now. You must finish your homework on time. So in here, they have given you a specific time. You should finish. You must finish your homework on time. It's a good habit. Okay, so next modal verb that I have got for you is should. So here is the use of it. We can express obligation. So here are a few examples. You should respect elders. It's a good habit, and you have to, you must, you should respect your elders. You should have your main meals on time. If you want to maintain a good health, of course, you have to have your meal on time. You should practice it very well. If you need to sing it well, of course, you have to practice this really very well. Okay, so next example, you should know your results by now. You should know your results by now. Okay, so here is the end of the lesson. So I hope you enjoyed the lesson, and yes, of course, stay home and be safe. God bless you.